Grandpa! Grandpa! You home?
Yep! Come on in!
Where do you think he is, Turkey?
Can't find him. Grandpa! You hiding?
I'm in the parlor! Come on in, youngins!
What's that, Gramps?
Well, Josh, that there is the Bible, the Holy Word of God.
Sure is a cool-looking book.
Grandpa, tell us a story now.
Jokey, I was a-fixin' to do just that.
I've got an idea. How about one with dinosaurs?
But, Grandpa, you said you'd tell us a story from your Bible.
All right, we'll do both. How about if Grandpa tells you a story about where dinosaurs came from? It sure is a fascinating tale, and a lot of folks are downright confused about it. They get so caught up in all their far-fetched Big Bang fairy tale nonsense, but they don't see the simple truth right in front of them.
Grandpa, what are you talking about?
Well, dinosaurs and the Bible, like you said.
Yeah, all right.
Calm down, calm down. Well, let's see. To tell this story right, I have to start at the beginning. And I do mean the very beginning. First off, let's hear some verses from the Bible about how this old world got started. It all began about 6,000 years ago when God created the earth.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day.
Wow! Is that what really happened, Grandma?
Sure is, Josh. And just wait till you see what happens next.
And God said, "Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters."
Grandpa, what is it?
Firmament. The expanse of the sky that separated the seas of the earth from the canopy of water above the earth.
And God called the firmament heaven. And the evening and the morning were the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. And God called the dry land earth, and the gathering together of the waters called he seas. And God saw that it was good.
Wow! Way cool!
Yo, Baba talks a little funny, Grandpa.
Well, Jokey, some folks might say we talk a little funny.
And God said, "Let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth." And it was so. And the evening and the morning were the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night. And let them be for signs, and for seasons, and for days, and for years." And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. And God set them in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth, and to rule over the day and over the night, and to divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the fourth day.
This is great, Gramps, but how come they didn't tell us in school?
Probably because most folks have been taught that nonsense about gaseous clouds coming from nowhere, colliding, and poof, bang! What a bucket of hogwash!
Grandpa, you said that before, but it don't make sense. The big what?
You're darn right it don't make no sense, and it gets my dander up. Don't get me started on evolution. We'd better listen to the Bible some more instead.
And remember, Grandpa, lots of dinosaurs. You promised.
Just hold on to your britches, young man. We're getting to the really good stuff.
And God said, "Let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and the fowl that may fly above the earth in the open firmament of heaven." And God created great whales and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind.
Woo-wee! God made the stars, the earth, the oceans, all the birds and fish, and we're only on day 5. Since you two are getting kind of anxious, we're gonna skip a few parts here and there.
And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. And the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him and help me for him." And out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air.
Man, oh man, he did all that in 6 days. I guess he did deserve a good rest on the 7th day.
Wow!
Exactly. And y'all did notice that man was made in God's image, not a monkey.
Grandpa, you're silly.
Yep, I've been accused of that before. Monkeys, I'm not quite ready for you yet. Let's get back to the first man. The Bible says that Adam got to give names to all the animals that God created. And Josh, I do mean all of them, if you know what I mean.
Autumn, Mom. Autumn, over here. Could we talk, Mom? You see, I have been waiting patiently in line, and I was a bit sad when you named the rhinoceros. I thought, for a grand lizard like myself, that would be a fine name, rhinoceros. Well, Mom, what shall it be?
Let me see. How about mouse? Have I used that yet?
Mouse. It has a certain ring, but I was thinking of something more impressive, like, shall we say, hippopotamus.
No, already used it. Okay. I got it. Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Oh, Tyrannosaurus Rex. How legal. Yes, I like it. But I don't want to appear presumptuous in front of the other animals.
Well, how about a nickname like, I don't know, T-Rex? Yeah, Tony the T-Rex.
Tony the T-Rex. It's a fine name, Mon. I shall wear it well. By the way, do you think you could do something about these stubby little arms of mine? Not to complain, but they're a bit short, Mon. I cannot scratch my nose. Be cool, Mon, and we shall sing you a song about the garden. Welcome to the garden. It's the place to be. Every kind of animal and beautiful trees. Very handsome, don't you think? He made me very large. Welcome to the garden. It's the place to be. There's every kind of animal and handsome T-Rexes like me. I'm sorry for you, little chameleon, but maybe one day you'll grow up big and handsome like me. If you like my singing, Mon, you should see me dance.
To be Adam's companion. So God made the first woman, Eve, and they lived together in the Garden of Eden, and it was a wonderful place. Now God told Adam and Eve that they could eat from every tree except one, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Wily old snake talked Eve into eating from that tree, even though God told him not to.
Come on, take a bite. See for yourself. You'll be just like God.
Don't do it.
Well, she did. She listened to him all right. And that was the beginning of the sin of all mankind.
Figures. It was a girl's fault.
From that day, the snake had to crawl on its belly and eat dust for the rest of its days. And then, God made Adam and Eve leave the garden forever.
Do you know any more about dinosaurs?
Well, okay. Let's see. Lots of time had passed since Adam...
Millions of years?
No, not millions of years. Actually, it was about 1,600 years. By this time, there were a whole lot of people on Earth, and the entire mess of them was bad.
Here, boss, don't strain yourself. Let me hold him down for you. You want me to kill him? I mean, I could kill him if you want me to. I don't mind. It's no trouble, really. I'd like to kill him!
Stop it now! Stop it right there! Get out of here, Jason, and take that no-good raptor with you. Easy there, young fella. Calm down. I'm not gonna let old Jason and Ivan hurt you anymore. Oh, God, why did you even create those two troublemakers? The whole world is just so full of anger. Thank God I've got my family.
Noah.
Lord.
The end of all flesh has come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them. And behold, I will destroy them with the earth. And behold, I do bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh wherein is the breath of life from under heaven, and everything that is in the earth shall die. But with thee will I establish my covenant, and thou shalt come into the ark, thou and thy sons and thy wife and thy sons' wives with thee. And of every living thing of all flesh, two of every sort shalt thou bring into the ark to keep them alive with thee.
Yes, Lord, as you command, it shall be done.
No, it just slipped. It's not too heavy. I mean, I didn't mean to.
Yeah, she's right. Maybe our little brother needs to bulk up a bit. I do 50 or so of these every morning. And as you can see by the size of my biceps, they really work.
Ooh.
Yeah, Runt, if you want, I can show you some more of my workout tips. They make you really strong.
Show you true strength.
Whoa! Oh! 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 Uh-oh!
Yeah, you're strong, all right. Strong smelling.
Boys, God just gave me the plan, and it's time to get to work.
Everybody's laughing 'cause we're a long way from the lake. We're listening.
don't make mistakes. I'm Hell.
I'm Jason.
And we're gonna build an ark. I'm Hell.
I'm Jason.
And we're gonna build a boat. I'm Hell.
I'm Jason.
And we're gonna build an ark. I'm Hell.
I'm Jason.
And we're gonna build a boat. Yo!
Ho!
Hey!
Ho!
We're gonna build an ark. Yo!
Ho!
Hey!
Ho!
We're gonna build a boat. Yo!
Ho!
Hey!
Ho!
We're gonna build an ark. Yo!
Ho!
Hey!
Ho!
We built this great big boat.
Here they come. Looks like we got her built just in time.
Man, they sure are runts.
Hello, they're babies.
Aw, and they're so cute.
If you say so.
It's okay by me if they're young ones. They won't eat as much.
Tail down, you carnivore wannabe.
Are you talking to me?
Well, if it isn't Ivan the Pretty Bad, why don't you go munch on some grass instead of that poor baby's tail?
Whatever you say, lady. Just call me Mr. Agreeable. I am a vegetarian, you know. How about the tour of this cruise liner?
No way, Ivan. Get out of here.
Talk about inhospitable. I didn't want to get on their stupid boat anyway.
My boss says it's not really going to rain anyway.
In my reservation.
No way, Ivan. We have reached our quota of raptors. Father Noah had an ark. E-I-E-I-O. And on that ark he had some ducks. E-I-E-I-O. With a quack here and a quack there. Here a quack, there a quack, everywhere a quack, quack. Father Noah had an ark. E-I-E-I-O. And on that ark he had. Not a chance, Ivan.
Oh, sissies. This is nothing. Let me in!
Ho! I'm almost 600 years old, and I've never seen anything like this before.
the 600th year of Noah's life, where all the fountains of the great deep broken up and the windows of heaven were opened. And the flood was 40 days upon the earth. And the waters prevailed and were increased greatly upon the earth. And the ark went upon the face of the waters. Upward did the waters prevail, and the mountains were covered. All in whose nostrils was the breath of life, of all that was in the dry land, died. And Noah only remained alive, and they that were with him in the ark. God remembered Noah and every living thing that was with him in the ark. And God made a wind to pass over the earth, and the waters assuaged. The fountains also of the deep and the windows of heaven were stopped, and the rain from heaven was restrained. And the waters returned from off the earth continually. And the ark rested upon the mountains of Ararat.
Every moving thing that liveth shall be meat for you, even as the green herb have I given you all things. Behold, I will establish my covenant with you. Neither shall all flesh be cut off any more by the waters of a flood, neither shall there any more be a flood to destroy the earth. I do set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be for a token of a covenant between me and the earth. And it shall come to pass, when I bring a cloud over the earth, that the bow shall be seen in the cloud. I will remember my covenant.
Well, that's a good place to stop for now. You two better hightail it on home now before your mama comes looking for you.
Do you know any more about dinosaurs?
You bet your lunchbox I do, but we don't have time for that today. You remind me next time you come, and we'll talk about dinosaurs after the flood.